A very warm welcome to today's session, in which I'm going to help you with certain programs in which we are going to use for and while. Okay, so let's see which programs I'm going to cover. So the first program I'm going to cover is I will help you to print the table of a number, and that number will be input by the user. So user will provide a number and I will print the table of that number. So suppose if the user will provide 3, so I will print the table of 3 for the user. Or if the user is providing me with 7 number, I will print the table of 7 for the user. So this program is going to be very flexible, and whatever input the user will give, it will react according to that. The second is to compute sum of natural numbers from 1 to n. So if you give it a range like 4, so it will help you to calculate the sum. So for 4, it will help with the sum of 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4. Okay, so if the range is 10, so it will give you the sum of all the numbers till 10. That is 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 plus 6, so on up to 10. So the user will provide a number and this program is going to generate the sum until that. So let's start with the programming part. So here I'm going to search for idle. So after going to idle, I am opening a new file. So this is the same process we are following every time. So first of all, I need to get the number from the user for which I want to generate the table. So let n is going to store my number. So n equals to eval input. So enter the number. As I was telling you that to just keep some space between your string and your input, you can just give a space here or a colon here so that your input and your string should not stick with each other. Okay, we have to close actually 2 brackets here. So now we are going to do it with the for loop. So for I in range, as you know that tables are always starting from 1, right? And it goes all the way till 10. But in case of for loop, it has one drawback that the last number, the last range that you mentioned is not considered. So if you want to get the range till 10, you have to write 11. Okay. If you will write 10 here, only it will work till 9. Okay. The last one is never considered. So if I want that the table should be printed till 10, so I have to go one number more than that. Okay, so for I in range 1 to 11, what I want to do, I want to print the table. And as we know that table is of the type, how we print the table, it's always like this, like 2, if it's a 2's table, so we will write 2 and then this, then 1 equals to 2. This is how it will work. Okay, so now keeping that in view, as we are getting the value from the user and from the user, it means I'm not going to keep it fixed. It means first of all, I'm going to write here n, right? Instead of 2, I will write the number that user is going to input, okay? So after getting the number, one thing will always remain fixed. This multiplication sign will always remain fixed. Now this 1 here will keep on changing. Now it is 2, 1's are 2, next time it will be 2, 2's are 4. So it will go all the way from 1 to 10. So here, I can't keep it fixed. So I am out of this string, so I will write here I, because I is keeping the track that from where you are going, you are going from 1 till 10, okay? And after that, again, something is fixed, so that is equals to sign. And the last one is how you are going to calculate this. It will be number multiplied by I. For example, if number is 2, 2 multiplied by 1 equals to 2. Next time it will be 2 multiplied by I, that is 2 equals to 4. Next time it will be 2 multiplied by I, which is 3 equals to 6. Next time it will be 2 multiplied by I, which is 4 equals to 8. So it means how to get the final value, it is always n and then multiply by I. Okay, so this 3 lines of code is actually helping you to print your table. Okay, so let's save this file with the name 7.py. Okay, and let's check what will be the output. I'm going to click on this run, right? And see, it will ask me to enter the number. So suppose I want the table of 4, so I'm entering 4. It will generate the table of 4. 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8, and so on till 40. Now you want to run it again, and this time you want the table of a bigger number. So suppose 128. it will generate that table for you also. So this is a flexible program. Okay, so it will take any number from you and will print the table of that number. After this, the next program that we are going to do is compute the sum of two natural numbers. Right, so m is being provided by the user and we are going to calculate the sum. Okay, so I need to start a new file, and here first of all I need to get the n from the user. So let's copy the same here, Control C, and copy the same thing here, and we are going to get the n, and then we have to do this program this time with the y. Although you can do it with for loop, but as we have done the program of multiplication with for loop already, so let's do it with the y. So for the while loop, you need to done the initialization on your own. So let's suppose I'm starting it with the one, because the first natural number is one. Okay. And then I am going to take one variable m that is going to store the sum of all the natural numbers. So in the beginning, when you are not calculating, you are just started. It means the sum is zero. So I'm setting the value to zero. Okay. So now I have to start my while loop. So while my i's value is still less than equals to n. It means i's value is 1 and n is 10. So it means you have to add it. Then i's value is 2. It is still less than 10. So you have to add it. Okay. So we have to work all the way till 10. And once this condition is satisfied, what you have to do? You have to generate a new sum. And every time your i's value will be added to the older value of sum. And together, these two values will be assigned to the new sum. Okay, and once you do this, you have to increment your I side by side. So I have to write I equals to I plus 1. I think that this same thing you are doing with your program in C and C++ also. The logic is always same. Okay, so it's not about logic that I'm telling you. It's about the Python, that how you can implement these things and how you can get familiar with the Python using the same concepts that you were doing in C++ previously. So next we will print the final. Okay, so let's save this program and let's give it a name, h.py. okay, and let's run this program and see what will be the output. So I am about to run it. So first of all, it will ask me the number that I want to enter. So suppose if I want that, I want to add all the numbers till 1 to 7. So it will give me the sum is 28. How you get the 28? So 28 is actually 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 plus 6 plus 7. It means all the numbers from 1 till 7, the range that you are giving. And this is the proof that yes, it is 28. Okay. So let's run it once more, and this time let's give the range 4 only. So you will get 10. How you are getting 10? So I'm proving here it is 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4, because 4 is the maximum range that you are giving. So it is 10. Okay. So I hope these two programs are clear, and with these programs, the loops, for loop and while loop is also clear. So keep practicing these loops on your own with the different programs, and I will see you again with new concepts, with new programs. Till then, keep learning, keep enjoying. Bye-bye. Take care.